And then we're just going to walk around the West Green right over here. And let's take a look. Let's take a look at what we're in for. And I've got 2 hours to do this. You are here. There's the convocation center. So basically, it looks like they're including, but here's the core of it. We're just gonna take a look around. A random walk. So let's get to it. This is the green I know the least about because I just never came down here. In fact, this might be the most extensively I've been through this area ever. This is cool. Thank you.
Yeah, this thing is...
Rush hour in Athens. even think there is a crosswalk. Is there a crosswalk? All right, Athens. Ohio University. I think you need a crosswalk right here, don't you? Maybe not. There's probably not too many people crossing here. Let's go this way.
That's the Peden Stadium, the football stadium, of course. Calhoun Baker. It's in Baker Center, right? Calhoun Baker. 1901 to 1920. Yeah, nice. Alston Ellis. Ellis Hall. We know Ellis. We know Alston. Just need to cut that back a little. You can read it. Get a weed whacker, guys. Oh, man. 1824. Oh, my God. Oh, Wilson. Wilson. Oh, my gosh. Robert Wilson. Look at this. Look at this. 1824 to 1839. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Here's Irvine. There's an Irvine Hall, right? James Irvine. James Irvine, 1822 to 1824. Oh my goodness, let's see how far back it goes. Oh my God, 1809. Jacob Lindley, Lindley Hall. 1809 to 1822. And here's the very first one, I think. Who's gonna be the winner? Who's gonna be the winner? Oh, it's just the school itself, 1804. Right? Yeah, so it's just the it's our beloved OU itself. How far back can we go? But I mean, when you consider that the country was officially begun in 1776, of course, settled before that, but and that the founders of this university were in George Washington's squad. In other words, they were drinking buddies. Yes, it's true. The founders of this university came up with the idea in a bar in Boston. You can look it up. This is the backside of Baker Center. Reminds me of houses in the Hollywood Hills, because on the top side, when you drive by, you just see this what seems to be a one-story, two-story building, but on the other side, it's a $25 million four-story house overlooking Los Angeles. This is a bird arena. Get some video of that. Okay, quick story. I grew up in Canada, more or less. And, facility closed until further notice. Home of Ohio hockey. So I grew up in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. More or less. We kind of moved around. And played hockey, played ice hockey. Then we moved back to the States. I went to high school in Iowa. Then we moved to Northeast Ohio, to Akron, Ohio. So I went to find where I could play hockey. Just to play hockey, just to have fun, basically. And the only thing I could find was Cleveland State University had a club team. I couldn't find anything in Akron, but in Cleveland State. Well, one time we went down to Athens, Ohio. This is the first time I'd ever been to Athens. I didn't even know anything about it. I was just fresh off the farm from Iowa. And had been in Ohio just a few months, I think. And they said, we're going to a road trip down to play Athens at Bird Arena. And I'm like, okay, what's Athens? Anyway. We got shelled by the OU hockey team. Shelled. And in those days, I haven't been inside Bird Arena for a long time. I assume it's different now. But in those days, they didn't have glass on the boards, above the boards. It was fencing, like chain link fence. So you're lined up, you know, for the face-off, up against the boards, and they can reach through the fence, or if you get squashed up against the boards, somebody smashing you into the boards. Did we go down here? You know, they're yelling in your ear. They're literally 2 inches from your ear, screaming in your ear as you get smashed. God, Athens was founded in 1797. I didn't know that. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense, but holy mackerel, dude, that is a long time ago. At one time. So I had played hockey, you know, most of my life, but I wasn't, you know, very good. I don't know. Yeah. Oh, let's see what this is. James Pertice. Maybe these names from the early 1900s, Pertice, unless that was his. The custom, and you still see it today sometimes, is the mother's maiden name will be their middle name. Professor of psychology. So, I've told this story many times, but I've told it on stage. It gets a huge laugh. But I'll just tell you the unfunny version. So I take the puck behind our net. I would say most of the players were not that good. And I might have been one of them. To tell you how bad I am, to show you how bad... No. To show you how bad our team was, I was one of the better players. To give you some context. So I take the puck behind our goal to kind of get organized and set things up, and you know. And I come out on one side of the goal, and there's one of the biggest players on OU right there waiting. Breaks. I take the puck. I stop. I take the puck back around the other way. I think, oh, you know, this guy is a big, you know, I just knew that because he was a bigger player, he wouldn't be very mobile. He wouldn't be very fast. Whereas I'm not very big, but I was fast. So I'm like, no problem. I'll go around the other way. You know, I've played hockey for years. This is easy. So I go around back the other way. On the other side of that net, behind, and then out the other way. And I swear to God, he's there. I'm like, this is when, you know, it used to be like, if you look at athletes now, like in the old days, there was a trade-off of speed versus size. And I think, you know, that's still the case. But today, while that's still generally the case, you have, you know, NBA players that are both big and fast, right? So I don't know if he was the, you know, precursor to that, but I swear to God, he somehow made it to the other side. Now, they were much better than us anyway, right? So they were like a level above. I don't know how we broke it down in terms of league. Of course, they were in the MAC, but or that actually was a club team. I don't know. But anyway, they were like a league above us, at least overall anyway. But this guy was big and fast in particular. And so he was on the other side. So I like, oh no. So I'm like, you know, my instinct was just to go back the other way. That he couldn't do it twice. So I go back around to the original side, and there he is again. And I swear to God, he hit me square in the chest, like, and basically lifted me up. This is in our own zone. This is right by your own goal, which is, you should never let this happen. What I'm letting happen, you should never let happen. And the place erupts, Bird Arena erupts, because I think, well, who knows, but it erupted. And I think particularly because they hit me. And the little dance we had going there kind of set it up, right? It was like setting up a joke, and then the punchline was, he just cleaned my clock. Cleaned it. And the one thing you want to do in all sports, at least this is the way I was taught, you never let it show. So I could barely breathe, right? But I get up and act like nothing happened, like it was not a problem, but I'm fighting for breath. Oh man. All right, let's go back here and double check our work before we turn it into the professor. I'm sure we missed something, but The title of this video will be Random Walk Around the West Green, because that's exactly what it was. Yeah, so we went, I think we kind of went like something like that, and then over here and around and okay. Let me get a little bit better video of that situation, and then we'll come over here, we'll get the west screen and the sports complex. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. All right, guys, there's your Ohio University West Green and environs. Actually looks good. Who's ever doing the landscaping at the school? Looks good. All right, that's not the last random walk around Athens and Ohio University, but at least it completes the main greens, and talk to you soon.